How is it going, everybody? Destauch here, and today I'm going to be talking about what I'm worried about in Halo Infinite. Now, I am still very much excited, perhaps too much so, perhaps zealously, but I am excited nonetheless, and I am also nonetheless pessimistic, because I am a gamer. So, let's get into what I am worried about Halo Infinite, and things that I think that they should avoid. First up, a muddied weapon arsenal. Now, what do I mean by that? Well, I think that Halo 1 through 3 had very good weapon rolls. Everything served a purpose and it was unique. But when Reach came around, we started to see more repetitive weapons. Look no further than the plasma rifle and the plasma repeater. Two weapons on the same faction that serve very similar roles. Now, I know that they were a little bit different, but you don't really need something that close to each other in the same sandbox on the same side. This issue was also compounded upon in later games, especially with a lot of the Promethean weapons. Weapons that functioned very similar to UNSC weapons, but nonetheless were their own weapons. In my opinion, similar weapons like this just make the game harder to balance and are just repetitive and not as fun to use. I'm saying all this because with the recent Mega Construct toy reveals, we've noticed that there's a lot of repetitive weapons, like the tactical shotgun, the regular shotgun, the return of the plasma repeater, and the plasma rifle. While these weapons certainly aren't a deal breaker, it's just something to be aware of, and I hope that they can properly balance the game and not have things be too similar to each other. Moving on to my next worry is muddied factions. Much like muddied weapons, muddied factions are also a thing that I'm worried about in Halo Infinite. Now, what do I mean by that? Well, we know that the Banished are likely in the game, and with the focus on Cortana, we could see the appearance of the Created. Now, this could be in the form of enslaved alien factions, or even Prometheans. And on top of that, we're also likely to see the Flood, so we could have three factions fighting at the same time. Now, while I'm sure if the game is large enough it could compensate for that many factions, I'm just worried that it will be unfocused and not have a clear antagonist. I think this also ties into the whole issue I have with Destiny, which I think with so many alien factions, none of them really stand out, especially in Destiny 1. We know about the Darkness, but a lot of the orbiting alien factions, they're not as intimidating. And it wasn't until Destiny 2 where we had a focused alien faction in the Cabal, where I really felt like the antagonists were intimidating. And I just want a singular focused enemy faction, just so that we can focus on them, build up their lore, and kind of build a rivalry with them. Much like how the Banished were treated in Halo Wars 2. Moving on to my next worry, which ties into our whole enemy faction, is Atriox. I hope that Atriox appears in the game, and I'm worried that they might kill him off like they did with Jul Mundama. Now, while Jul Mundama certainly wasn't the most memorable Halo antagonist, I feel like he had a lot of potential, and they just killed him off at the beginning of Halo 5, and all of that potential was basically destroyed. Now, what sparks a lot of this worry is the recent Halo Infinite teaser with the Banished message. The Banished basically say that they are the legacy of somebody, and that somebody is most likely Atriox. Now, when you say that you're the legacy of someone, it kind of implies that they're dead, which I certainly hope is not the case. Luckily, I think that he probably won't be dead. He's probably just stranded on the Ark because his capital ship was destroyed. But even still, I still find it pretty disappointing that he may not be in Halo Infinite. Even if it's a contrived reason and he's alive, it's just, I wish he would be there because he builds to the presence of the Banished and is a really great antagonist. I really don't see the logic of bringing back the Banished, but removing Atriox. It just doesn't make sense to me, so hopefully he'll return. And finally, but certainly not least, I sincerely hope that armor abilities do not return. Yes, I know a lot of people like them. I am a Halo purist, and even I can concede and say perhaps some of them can return, maybe thrusting to a limited capacity, but I just really hope that they don't take the base of Halo 5 and make it the base of Halo Infinite. I think things like Round Pound and Spartan Charge really don't complement the sandbox of Halo. Sprint as well. I know that Sprint is kind of an industry standard, but I just don't think it needs to be in Halo. If you increase the movement speed of Halo, you don't need Sprint. To me, all Sprint does is remove your ability to fire, and it promotes a lot of chaotic gunplay, which, to me, Halo isn't about. Halo is about scoping out an enemy and having a really competitive 1v1 with them by outmaneuvering them on a fight-by-fight basis. So basically, not about maneuvering the map and getting off the first shot on someone, more about outmaneuvering them in a gunfight. To me, sprint is best suited for games like Call of Duty, where you're trying to get around the map quickly and outmaneuver people at a map scale. The difference is, Halo, you're not really maneuvering around the map to shoot someone in the back and get the first shot off. You're really maneuvering so that you can strafe and get off a headshot. That's what Halo's about to me, and sprint doesn't really fit into that mold. And with that final controversial topic, that was basically everything I'm worried about in Halo Infinite. And luckily, a lot of these things aren't major things. I'm actually pretty impressed with Halo Infinite so far. At least, you know, what we've seen of the two trailers in terms of art style and stuff. I mean, who am I kidding? It could all fall apart in the end. But I'm hoping it doesn't. I hope 343 can make a great Halo game. And if you guys have any thoughts, please leave them in the comments. This was Destauch, and I'll see you in the next one. Destauch out.